Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to discuss about workflow rules in Salesforce. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So now I am going to discuss about workflow rule in Salesforce. So first of all, introduction of workflow rule. So workflow rule automates the task we do manually. So whenever you create or edit any record, and after creation or modification of any record, you do some tasks that are done manually. So you can automate those tasks or things with the help of workflow rule. So let's say, for example, the emails you send regularly or field update you do manually. You can configure workflow rules so that these tasks can be automated based on certain criteria. So here you can see two things are mentioned, emails and field update. So these are two key features that we can implement automatically with the help of workflow rules. So if you are sending emails manually or you are updating fields manually, so you can automate those things with the help of workflow rules. So these four things we can do automatically with the help of workflow rules. So you can create tasks and assign a task to user, role, or record owner. Second, you can send email alerts, or you can say you can send emails to one or more recipients. Third is field updates. So you can update value of fields of a record. And fourth is outbound messages. So you can send a secure configuration API in XML format to a designated listener. So these four things you can do with the help of workflow rules. Now, to do these things, we need to implement two criteria. So one is evaluation criteria and second one is rule criteria. So evaluation criteria works when your record is created or edited. So it focuses on two parts. Either your record is created or it is edited or both, right? So here three options are available. First is created. Second is created and every time it's edited. And third one is created and every time it's edited to subsequently meet criteria. So based on these options, if any one of is selected and it is true, then workflow rule matches its rule criteria. So in rule criteria, you can mention two things. Either you can set a criteria that should be met, or you can implement formula that should be evaluated to true, right? So if your record is created and criteria or formula matches or formula is true, then workflow rule will fire. Or suppose you selected second option like created and every time it's edited, or third option and your rule criteria matches or formula evaluates to true, then also your workflow rule will be executed. Now, you might be thinking, what is the difference between these two, created and every time it's edited, and created and any time it's edited to subsequently meet criteria. So in case of the second point, that is created and every time it's edited. So in this case, if you are editing your record and your rule criteria is matching, then workflow rule will be fired. And in third case, which is created and anytime it's edited to subsequently meet criteria. So in this case, if you are editing your record and based on that record editing, if your rule criteria is matching or formula is evaluating to true, then only your workflow rule will be executed. So I am also going to demonstrate these differences in my demonstration videos. So you can watch those another videos to understand this practically. So after understanding evaluation criteria and rule criteria, next thing comes, that is action. So there are two actions that workflow rule provides. First is immediate action. Here the statement is rule executes immediately when a record matches the criteria. So if you want to execute any action whenever your criteria matches, so you can define them under immediate action. Now, second is time dependent action. So if you want to execute a particular action on a particular time, then you can implement them under time dependent action. So here the statement is, rule always queues when a record matches the criteria and executes according to the time trigger. So here you can set a particular time bound when your action will be executed. So you can choose either immediate action or time dependent action as per your requirement. Then two things that you remember, that you have to remember. So first is activated and second is deactivated. So if you want to run your workflow rule, you must activate it after setting criteria and action. Otherwise it won't work. Then if you want to add or edit time dependent workflow action, then you need to deactivate your workflow rule first, then you can do this. Now how you can see your time based workflow? So you can search time based workflow in quick find of setup. So the statement is, when a workflow rule triggers, its time dependent actions are placed in a work in the workflow queue. Use the criteria to monitor queue. So you can see the queue, which workflow rules are available. So you can search a workflow rule name or object or schedule date, created by user ID or record name. So you can choose any one from this list. You can choose any operator like equals, not equals, less than, greater than, or other. Or you can fill the desired thing as per the choice you selected. And accordingly, your queue will be filtered out and you will see all time-based workflows listed there. So this way you can see which workflows are based on time. So this way, I hope you understood a brief about this workflow rule. If you want to watch demonstration related to workflow rules, so you can go to my channel and you can search for the playlist related to workflow. There you will find out videos related to workflow rule implementation. So thank you for watching this video.